And they just did Bar Bones, my new chapbook of poetry, as a poet laureate. So I'm going to read from this. And I thought, I don't know, I started getting very family, thinking about family. So I'm going to read a couple poems about my family. And I'm going to start with poems to my two youngest sons. And this is called Moonlight to Water for my youngest sons, Ruben and Luis. Ruben recalled the day I brought Mama and his baby brother home when he was six. In the back seat of the car, he said, was an Asian-looking child, hair sticking straight up on his head. Chito, short for Luisito, looked this way because he's part Raramuri and Huichol, but mostly our universe. Ruben must have wondered about the galaxy of stars, bird songs, and stories that had been dreamt to fashion such a boy. When Chito arrived, I'm sure Ruben knew his world would never be the same. Until then, Ruben had been our only child. To Mom and Dad, he was the screech of car brakes, a sigh to our bad jokes, the glove to our ball, and now this, a bewildered boy gazing at a sweet-faced earth child wrapped in a light blue blanket. I asked Ruben what he thought about his brother. Eyes gleaming with his six-year-old's clarity, he answered, "Oh, I already knew him. I saw Chito when I was in Mama's stomach." I gave Ruben a look I often offered to, in reply to his amazing observations. Somehow, though, the statement rang true. His younger brother was in the wings, preparing to part, the next one patiently abiding his turn. As they grew older, Chito followed his brother's every move, entering wide-eyed into Ruben's dense sphere, sharing the same music, games, imaginings. Ruben never hurt or exploited him, as older brothers often do. The boys connected from the start, like hummingbird to flower, like breath to poems, like moonlight to water, brothers since the womb.